I think it's quite interesting how it's always dark-skinned girls that seem to dislike me without even knowing me. What's your insecurity? I'm quite intrigued to know.
Oh, boo-hoo! Let me play a sad song for you on the world's smallest violin.
Chandler Alexis is clearly wilding. Like, I don't know why she thought it was okay to say this. I don't know why she thought that this was a reasonable explanation as to why people don't like her, because she's not known for anything good. What up, what up, what up, everybody? I am the Mademoiselle, and this is my channel. Today, we are going to be talking about the light skin versus dark skin shit for the simple fact that you guys will not let me live because you keep tagging me in this Chandler Alexis BS. Now, before I get into this, y'all know, I haven't talked about that girl. If you've been here before, I used to make videos about her shenanigans, and she was always in some shit back in the day. However, she has calmed down a lot, especially ever since she had her son. She won't be in no mess no more. But right now, she is currently being dragged for basically making a comment about dark skins hating on her, okay? So before we get into all of that, a few disclaimers. They're doing construction outside. I thought we were quarantining. I didn't know that that was still a thing, but apparently it is. So if you hear that, I'm sorry. Second, I broke a nail and I had a band-aid over it to try to like stop it from falling out or whatever, but it didn't work. So, yeah, the ghetto, excuse it, I'm sorry. And third of all, cop this hoodie, okay? This is my nappy is happy sweatshirt or whatever. It's in my merch store, right? Chandler Alexis is being dragged for filth all over Instagram, all over Twitter because of this tweet.
I think it's quite interesting how it's always dark-skinned girls that seem to dislike me without even knowing me. What's your insecurity? I'm quite intrigued to know.
Oh, boo-hoo! Let me play a sad song for you on the world's smallest violin.
Then she goes on to say on her story, right?
Statistically, this is what most girls who dislike me, don't know me personally, and I've never met me, look like.
She takes a screen capture of all these girls that potentially hate her on her, were dark skin, were on her page or whatever, and she posts that to her story. Then she says,
what do they have in common besides their insecurity? But these are the same people that will complain that a guy will choose me over them. Honestly, it's not because of my complexion. It's because you're the type of person to hate someone because of how they look. I'm the type of person to hate someone because of who they are. Guys can sense a confident one over an insecure one.
People are dragging her, okay? And with reason. Now, I don't even know where to start with this, but we just gonna start. This video may be all over the place, and I'm sorry. First things first. Now, I'm not one to sit here and talk about YouTubers all day for the simple fact that I don't give a fuck for what they do. The only time I really talk about YouTubers is when they do stupid shit like this, and it pertains to what I talk about on my channel, which is social issues. And particularly social issues that deal with the Black community or parenting. Now, people are calling her colorist because of these tweets. Colorism is basically discrimination based on one's skin tone. Not race, not ethnicity, not gender, skin tone. So light skin, dark skin, brown skin, green skin, pink skin, purple skin, all that. So basically, when motherfuckers be sitting there like,
ooh, she dark skin, I don't wanna date her, but I love them light skin Johns. They not aggressive like that dark skin John.
That is considered colorist.
We might as well give the light-skinned one a job because, you know, the dark-skinned one's a little aggressive.
Or,
The light-skinned boy, he a little too sensitive or whatever, so we're gonna go with the dark-skinned one because we think, like, he'll hold up better. Oh, man, them light-skinned niggas, they soft. We don't want them light-skinned niggas at all.
That's all colorist, okay? Whether you are being colorist towards a dark-skinned person or a light-skinned person, telling the light-skinned person they're not Black enough, or telling the dark-skinned person that they're too dark, it's colorism. And I feel like a lot of people forget that. There's a lot of people that believe that only dark-skinned people can suffer through colorism. And that's ridiculous to me, and that's just not fair. There's too many people out there
who just like to wallow in their own problems and forget that there's other people out there that have issues too. It's not just dark-skinned people. It's not just black people. It's not just North American black people. There's black people all over the world that have all types of different issues, and I feel like all of those need a special type of attention. With that being said, I feel like light-skins do have their own types of issues. Now, let me just say this. Clear out, okay, before I say anything else. Dark-skinned girls really have it hard. Not all dark-skinned girls. It depends on where you're from. It depends on how you're raised. It depends on how you perceive things. It depends on a lot of things. However, there's a lot of dark-skinned girls who have went through a lot of shit just because of the color of their skin. And that is not to be messed with at any point, on any level, to any end, no matter if you are white commenting on it, black commenting on it, a man, woman, whatever. You should never comment on it and try to diminish what these women went through, because this is something that they still have to battle and they still have to fight. The color of their skin does deprive them of certain opportunities and does cause a lot of issues for them maneuvering throughout the world, okay? Whether it's jobs, education, opportunities, relationships, they go through it. Now again, the reason I said not all is because I've come across so many dark-skinned women who said they've never experienced colorism. And I found this shit shocking. I have a lot of friends that say they never experienced it. And it's just like, I can't take their experiences from them. You can't make someone believe or not believe what they believe at the end of the day. If you say that you're dark-skinned and you did not experience colorism or you did not perceive it that way, I'm not about to tell you what happened to you. And I feel like a lot of people try to, like, especially in the black community, try to push their opinions on other people and don't like it when other black people or other people in general don't agree with them. As soon as you don't agree with them, all of a sudden you're a colorist or this or that and all this extra shit. And it's just like, first of all, we need to learn to disagree to agree, period. And I don't mean agree to disagree. I said disagree to agree. What she said was wrong for the simple fact that she's trying to say that, like, basically only dark-skinned girls are the ones that are hitting on her. First of all, the screen capture does not mean that all those girls are dark-skinned. Let's be real here. A lot of people, especially like when it comes to fan accounts or people that like just make Instagrams to watch the people that they really like, or, you know, just to troll the internet, a lot of the times those profile photos are not them. So I don't know if she really sat there and clicked on every single one of those people and found out that they were dark-skinned. But okay, not only that, lighting makes a huge difference. I consider myself brown-skinned. But a lot of people consider me darker. A lot of people consider me lighter. I consider myself brown. I feel like I'm in the middle. Depending on who you are, where you're from, the lighting, the picture may look lighter, I may look darker. So the fact that she's basing her followers' pictures off of, oh, okay, well,
they're dark skin, they hate on me,
it's just absolutely ridiculous to me. Not only that, even if that were the case, I don't think she understands her audience. Her audience is mainly black girls. So I mean, light skin, dark skin, brown skin, whatever, they're mainly black girls. So if someone ends up hating on you because of some bullshit that you did, just know your audience is mainly black. Just like my audience is mainly black. I'm not gonna expect many white people to comment about the bullshit that I do or to comment on my videos or show me love or whatever. Most likely it's going to be black people because that's who my audience is. The same people who built you up will definitely take you down, especially when you do some bullshit. That brings me to my next point. Chandler Alexis is not known for any good things. Let's be real here. Most of her success has been attributed to drama. So the fact that she's sitting here trying to act like she just be minding her business and people be bothering her, I can agree that she's definitely stayed out of trouble this time. She definitely has. Like, she hasn't been in shit for a long time. However, it's like, anytime someone hears about you, it's about some motherfucking mess. So it's like, your name is not associated with anything good, so you can't expect anything good from it. So because of this backlash, Chandler Alexis sat here and made a two-part video to basically capitalize off her bullshit, okay? And she talked about a whole bunch of rumors that have been spreading ever since she was with her ex. In particular, she was talking about how people are trying to say that she was dating an underage boy and all this hoopla. I'm not even gonna get into that. I don't know, I don't care. But in the second video, that's when she addressed all of these situations with, you know, people saying that she's a colorist for her comments. I've been called a colorist on YouTube for defending light-skinned girls and their problems. Personally, I don't really give a shit because I know I'm not a colorist. I sit here and I defend and talk about dark-skinned girls' likes problems on a regular basis. So the fact that some people took my comments as colors because I didn't agree with whatever the fuck they said was absolutely ridiculous to me, and that's not okay. I never sat up here and said bullshit like she said. However, for whatever reason, I'm a colorist, okay? I was able to sympathize with a lot of issues that a lot of light-skinned girls have. The fact that I believe that light-skinned people have their own set of issues and dark-skinned people have their own set of issues, and no one's issues, light-skinned, dark-skinned, brown-skinned, any other race, any type of gender, whatever's issue should be compared. I believe every type of person, every type of class, every type of person has their own types of issues that should be recognized, discussed, held different planes. I don't believe anyone's issue should be compared because that's just not fair. Nobody's situations are the same. A light-skinned person and a dark-skinned person does not go through the same thing. A black person and a white person does not go through the same thing. Can they be similar? Maybe, but it's not the same. And I'm tired of people doing that. Like, people will really sit there and be like,
oh, well, I'm dark-skinned and this happened to me. I can't believe that that happened to you. Well, I had it worse than you, so you have no reason to complain.
That's absolute bullshit. I feel like we need to do a better job at acknowledging that other people have issues too. It's not just us. Everyone has their own issues, and it needs to be addressed as such. Stop comparing people's issues. Stop saying that some people are not entitled to have their own different feelings and opinions because other people are going through worse shit than them. That's not okay. Not okay. And in Chandler Alexis's video, she did talk about how she was always told that she was not black enough. So she was always being deprived of her black identity. Now, keep in mind that Chandler Alexis is black and Hispanic, okay? I don't know what Hispanic country she's from. From her video, she said that her mom is black, and in particular, her mom is dark-skinned. Her sister's dark-skinned. They raised her, blah, blah, blah. She was raised by her dark-skinned mother. There's no way she can be colorist. Personally, that's not true. Anyone can be colorist. It doesn't matter who you were raised from, who you date, whatever. You can be colorist and date a colorist, procreate with a colorist, be the product of a dark-skinned person and be colorist, or a light-skinned person and be colorist. The point I'm trying to get is anybody could be colorist, okay? Doesn't matter who raised you, where you come from. So I don't know where she was getting to with that, but it's very interesting how she did share her experience. And I've had a lot of light-skinned friends as well, and they tell me the same thing. They're like, yeah, dark-skinned girls made fun of me. It's the same situation with Queen when people were dragging her and I dragged her when she was basically saying, oh, them little nappy-headed black girls with hair, with bad hair or whatever. I don't remember what she said. Black girls with bad hair that always made fun of her. The thing is, with saying these types of things is not only is your audience predominantly black, you're definitely going to offend them. It's the simple fact that you shouldn't say these types of things for the simple fact that when you say these types of things, you group everyone in the same bubble and in the same box. You're alienating your subscribers and you're basically putting them in a negative light by saying that. Now, she would have said something more specific, like, look at these girls who are always da-da-da-da-da coming at me. And she would have left it at that. That would have been fine. But her basically grouping them all in one thing, saying, okay, these are the dark-skinned girls. These dark-skinned girls are the ones that are coming at me, is not okay. Because at the end of the day, bitch, I'm sure there's plenty of light-skinned, white, Hispanic girls who drag you, who you just don't catch. Okay, this is the thing, right? If I'm only at, 15, 16,000 subscribers on Instagram, and I can't catch everyone that's liking or leaving hate comments, I guarantee you, with her following, there's no way she can really catch all of these people that are posting hate comments about her. It's just kind of impossible. It's hard to keep track of all of these people. So it's very interesting how she really found the time to just do that, knowing damn well that her audience is predominantly black, because clearly they're not gonna feel okay with it. Do I think that she's a colorist? Not necessarily. I feel like she's just very ignorant to the issues that a lot of dark-skinned girls face and black people face as a whole.
Whoosh, child, mes amis, mbaka pop. Can we just talk about how this girl really thinks that being biracial and being light-skinned is the same thing? Like, I can't believe it, okay? Ladies and gentlemen, being biracial and being light-skinned is not the same thing. You can be 100% black and be light-skinned. You could be biracial and be dark-skinned. It has no limits, okay? You can be biracial and look any type of way. There's no one sole black look or one sole biracial look. Clearly, there is a certain way that predominantly biracial people, black people, or white people look like, and so on and so forth. However, you cannot just look at someone and be like, oh, well, they're light-skinned. That means they're mixed. That's absolutely not true. Like, I can't believe it. Y'all need to watch who y'all support, because shit like this is just not okay. Like, she really thought that she was saying something educated there, and she really wasn't. This should just be common sense, but I guess common sense is not as common as we all think.
Maybe she just didn't experience these things, and that goes back to my point of sometimes you can't tell someone or make someone feel how you feel. You can't take someone's experiences away from them, nor can you give them experiences to experience on the behalf of your opinion. At the end of the day, even though we all may be black, even though we may all be human, we do not all experience the same things. Personally, I think she's ridiculous in general, and I don't know how the hell she still has a following. A very problematic person, and she's not known for doing anything good, and she's also fucking manipulative to her audience. So the fact that she still has a following and you guys still follow her and you have the nerve to be tagging me in this shit shows that you need to do something with yourself and check the people you follow. Because to be sitting here getting upset about this type of shit, y'all the same people that follow all these other people that don't need to be followed and then complain later. Now, this whole light skin, dark skin thing is really, really problematic because it does divide us. Did we start it? No. Do we perpetuate it? Yes. Is it okay? No. Because at the end of the day, there's millions of black people around the world who are suffering because of this. They're being discriminated against because of the color of their skin, and it's not okay. It's really fucked up because there's so many talented dark-skinned women or talented light-skinned women who never, ever, never be given certain opportunities just because of the color of their skin. Better yet, just because they're black. Okay, let's just say that, just because they're black. But the color of your skin can definitely play a role as well. Now, if you're watching this and you are dark-skinned, light-skinned, white-skinned, whatever, okay, even though that this is the reality that we live in, we need to be aware, but we also can't let this be a crutch. Okay, I feel like at this point in time, we live in a climate that people use a lot of this shit as a crutch.
Oh, well, I'm not gonna go to that modeling gig because, you know, I'm dark skinned. They're not gonna pick me anyway.
Oh, I can't go talk to him. He looks like he likes light skinned girls.
Oh, well, I can't go to this job interview with my afro because, you know, they're not gonna take me.
Realistically speaking, if you keep doing that shit and you keep having that mindset, that's absolutely what's going to happen to you. You attract the energy that you want. You attract the energy that is given to you. If you go out in the world thinking, I'm black, I can't do this. I'm light skinned, they won't like me. I'm dark skinned, they already hate me. I'm this, I'm that, I got this, I got that. And this is going to stop me from being who I want to be. It is gonna stop you from being who you want to be. We need to realize, yes, this is what happens, but no, I will not let this stop me. I feel like there is just way too many people. And this is not even just black people, this is people in general. Okay, people in general have a habit of finding that one negative thing about them. That one thing that sets them apart that may be seen as a negative or is an insecurity within them. And they project it out to the world and use it as a crutch as to why they can't do anything. And it's really a problem. Because if you really sit there and you go around maneuvering the world believing that you can't do something just because of the color of your skin, you're really not going to be doing anything because of the color of your skin. And then when it doesn't happen, you're gonna blame it again on the color of your skin. Go out there, do what you want to do, do it how you want to do it. And if someone doesn't want to fuck with you because of the color of your skin, on to the next. It's not the end of the world. Yes, there's people that don't like you because you're light skin, because you're dark skin, because you're white. Is that going to stop you? Shouldn't, and that's up to you. If you let that stop you, that's up to you. A million doors close, but you can always make your own door. A million opportunities may pass you by, but you can create your own opportunity. People can drag you all fucking day, but you don't have to listen. Mind over motherfucking matter, y'all. That's all I'm saying. I just don't even understand why y'all still watching this girl. I don't know what she gives to y'all in terms of entertainment, in terms of education, in terms of common sense, but that's y'all business. Y'all wanna follow these dumbass people and then complain when they do dumbass shit. She ain't never had a good motherfucking track record. So I just want to understand, what did y'all expect? With that being said, I'm done with this video. Let me know what you think about the situation down in the comment section below. Do you believe that Chandler Alexis was justified in her comments? Do you believe that there's some truth to her comments? Do you believe that everything she said was a whole bunch of hoopla? Personally, I believe that she should have worded that a lot better. She worded that shit horribly, and she definitely is not the messenger for that because she ain't known for nothing good anyway, and her audience is predominantly black. So I don't know what the fuck she was talking about. So yeah, leave your comment down below. Make sure you get your merchandise. Like, share, subscribe, I do all that. And I'ma see y'all next time.